five or none. For those someone's out there, that life already coming like a nightmare. And you couldn't see everywhere the famine and the fear, the doubt and the drought, desperation and despair. You could see it all around, how the massacres abound, dead bodies all around, the atrocities abound, missing persons can't be found, dictators get the truth, new clowns are quickly found. The eagle and the bear are people living in fear of impending nuclear warfare. But as a matter of fact, believe it or not, plenty of people never care whether it's imminent or not. First one to attack or if the human race was going to survive or not. For those of us out there, that life already coming like a nightmare.
Defending
So get you ready for war, war. Freedom is a very fine thing, and all oppression can do is bring passion to the heights of eruption. Songs of fire we will sing. Go, go, no run. It's so your siren on is war now. War, war. The special patrol will fall like a wall force down our encounters with us. Even though them think them bold, but we know them cold like ice. We fear these fires. Choose your weapon then quick. All we need is buckles and bricks and sticks. We have fists, we have feet, we carry them the mighty routine. Send for the runner squad quick, because we're running wild. We think alike by blood will guide their way. And I say, all we're doing is defending. So get you ready for war, war. Freedom is a very fine thing.
Thank you very much. Hello and good evening to you. I last played this festival, I think, in 1997, long time ago. I think we last toured America with the dub band in about 10 years ago. And I resolved then that I would never, ever be coming back to the United States of America to tour with a band again. The audiences were fantastic, but the production left a lot to be desired. And it took Warren Smith and his powers of persuasion, his powerful powers of persuasion, to persuade me to come back to the United States to take part in the Sierra Nevada World Music Festival. I can't tell you what we had to go through to get here. It's been an absolute nightmare trying to get work permits to come from Europe to come here to play to you, but we did it. And we're happy to be here. So I want to say a big respect to Warren Smith and Epiphany. I want to say respect to all singers and players of instruments taking part in this festival. And I want to say maximum respect to Jimmy Cliff, the elder statesman of reggae music, a giant upon whose shoulders those of us who came after all stand. Well, it's a bit chilly tonight. I've never experienced this kind of weather in the United States before. It reminds me of London. So I'm gonna try and bring the tempo up a little bit. I want to do for you a couple of anti-fascist numbers from the 1970s. Now, you know, fascism has been resurgent in Europe for the last 30 years or so. Fascist organizations have formed themselves into political parties, and they have become more insidious, and they are growing stronger and stronger year by year. So we have to be in Europe constantly and alert and vigilant against the threat of fascism. So here's an old anti-fascist number called Fight Them Back.
Fascists on the attack, come back with fight them back.
Fascism the attack, make we counter-attack. Fascism the attack, come make we drive them.
Fascist fighter by the name of Blair Peach was murdered by the paramilitary arm of the British police force, the Special Patrol Group. This is a number dedicated to his memory. It's called Reggae for Peach. Everywhere you go, it's the talk of the day. Everywhere you go, you hear people say that the Special Patrol, them a murderer, we can't make them get no further up. The SPG, them a murderer, we can't make them get no further up. But them kill Blair Peach, the teacher. Them kill Blair Peach, the dirty leaders. Blair Peach was an ordinary man. Blair Peach took a simple stand. Against the fascists and the wicked plan. So they beat him till his life was gone. And everywhere you go, it's the talk of the day. Everywhere you go, you hear people say that the Special Patrol, them a murderer. Murderer, we can't make them get no further up. The SPG, them a murderer. Murderer, we can't make them get no further up. And them kill Blair Peach, the teacher. Them kill Blair Peach, the dirty leader. Blair Peach was not an Englishman. Them come from New Zealand. Now them kill the man, him dead and gone. But his memory lives on. Oh, ye people of England, great injustices are committed upon the land. How long will he permit them to carry on? Is Europe becoming a fascist place? The answer lies at your own gate, and in the answer lies your fate. Victory that the African Caribbean community in Britain won in our cultural struggles for Carnival. This one is called Forces of Victory. forces of victory and we're coming right through. We're the forces of victory now. What you gonna do? We make a little bait. 1978 and we fight and we fight and defeat the state. And all of us just forward up to nothing in here. And all of us just forward up to nothing in here. We're the forces of victory and we're coming right through. The forces of victory now. What you gonna do? We dressed in red and we feeling dread. Dressed in green and we're feeling mean. We're dressed in purple and we're dressed in yellow. We're dressed in blue and we're coming right through. We're the forces of victory and we're coming right through. The forces of victory now, what you gonna do? We're coming with our army, so put your head army. We're coming with the plane, it's gonna drive you insane. We're coming with our guns and we're making the rounds. We're coming with our tanks and Babylon dead. Forces of victory and we're coming right through. We're the forces of victory now. What you gonna do? If you call a physician to the poor opposition, they got no ammunition and they got no position. If you call a physician to the poor opposition, they got no ammunition and they got no position. Forces of victory and we're coming right through. We're the forces of victory now. What you gonna do? Eh? Black youth of my generation were criminalized by racist police officers. Criminalized under a law called the Vagrancy Act, dating back to the 19th century, which was used to control the movements of the unemployed during the time of Queen Victoria. Of course, this law was forgotten about until the youth, the black youth of my generation, emerged on the scene, whereupon it was suddenly rediscovered and used against us mercilessly. And you were always convicted of attempting to steal from persons unknown. Your alleged victim was never produced in court to give evidence against you. It was your word against the police officers. Well, during the 1970s, we had a campaign to get rid of this unjust law, and I contributed this poem to the campaign called Sonny's Letter. Brixton Prison, Jeb Avenue, London Southwest 2, England. Dear Mama, good day. I hope that when these few lines reach you, they may find you in the best of health. Mama, I really don't know how to tell you this, cause I did make a solemn promise to take care of little Jim and try my best to look out for him. Mama, I really did try my best, but nonetheless, I'm sorry to tell you, sir, poor little Jim, get a rest. It was the big lot of rush hour, when everybody just a hustle and a bustle for the home for the evening shower. Me and Jim stand up waiting for a bus, not causing no fuss. When all of a sudden, a policeman pull up. Out from three policemen, the whole of them carrying baton. Them walk straight up to me and Jim. One of them hold on to Jim. Say, I'm taking him in. Jim tell him to let go of him. For him to do nothing. And him not a thief, not even a button. But Jim start to wriggle. The police start to giggle. Mama, me can tell you what them do to Jim. Mama, me can tell you what them do to him. Them thump him in the belly and it turn to jelly. Them lick him on him back and him rip dead hot. Them lick him on him head but it tough like lead. Them kick him in the seed and it start to bleed. Mama, I just couldn't stand up there and I do nothing. So me took one in him eye and him started to cry. Me thump one in him mouth and him started to shout. Me kick one pon him shin and him started to spin. Me thump him pon him chin and him drop pon a bin and crash. And then, mama, four policemen come down and beat me to the ground. Them charge him for sus. Them charge me for murder. Mama, don't fret, don't get depressed and down on you. Be of good courage till I hear from you. I remain your son, son. Fighters, our freedom fighters. One such freedom fighter I would like to remember tonight is Dr. Walter Rodney. Dr. Walter Rodney wrote the seminal book, How Europe Underdeveloped Africa, and was leader of the Working People's Alliance in his native Guyana, and was murdered by the fascist regime of Forbes Burnham in 1980. Reggae for Rodney. You know, see how the crowd them just come sat up on me dream. Please sit up on me dream like a dark silk screen. A dark silk screen over the vision I had seen. The vision I had seen. The vision I had seen. Some may say that Walter Rodney was a victim of hate. Some may say that he gone through heaven's gate. Some may say that Walter Rodney shouldn't take up history weight and go carry it on his back like he did wear him on a rock. But look how the crowd them come suck up on me dream. He sit up on me dream like a shout or a scream. A shout or a scream or a really ugly scene that awake me from the dream that alert me to the scheme. Some may say that Walter Rodney was a prisoner of fate. Some may say that he'd gone through the hero's gate. Some may say that Walter Rodney couldn't take his true weight. So him take it off him back and go put it on him lap and go fall in a trap and so burn him get he drop. You must see how the dream come just get blown to smithereen. Him blown to smithereen in the middle of the dream. The middle of the dream before the people them come in. The people them come in. Some may say that Walter Rodney was not sharp for the sea, and all that him did want was for setting people free. With the workers and the peasants, it should have operated but like a fish to the hook. It go by Pam Vernon beat. But look how my dream come just get blown to smithereen. Him blown to smithereen in the middle of the dream. The middle of the dream before the really crucial scene. The really crucial scene is when the people them come in. Here in America heard about the riots that we had in England last year. Well, what sparked off the riots was the cold-blooded killing by the police of a black man named Mark Duggan. But the riots, which began in Tottenham in North London, spread throughout the nation. So it has to be seen in the context of racial oppression and racial injustice, class oppression and social injustice, and in the wider context of the austerity measures brought about by this current crisis in capitalism. Back in the 1980s, we had similar riots, which was also sparked off by race and class oppression. And I wrote a couple of poems about those riots. One was called The Great Insurrection, and the other was called Making History. I'm gonna do both of them for you tonight. I'm gonna do The Great Insurrection a cappella and Making History with the band. The Great Insurrection. It was in April 1981. Down in the ghetto of Brixton, that the Babylon them cause such a friction that it bring about a great insurrection. And it spread all over the nation. It was truly an historical occasion. It was event of the year, and I wish I had been there when we run riot all over Brixton. When we mash up plenty police van. When we mash up the wicked one plan. When we mash up the Swamp 81, fi what? Fi make the rule of them understand that we not take no more of them oppression. And when we check out the ghetto grapevine, fi find out all I could have find. Every rebel just a revel in them story. Them a talk about the power and the glory. Them a talk about the burning and the looting. Them a talk about the smashing and the grabbing. Them a tell me about the vanquish and the victory. Them said the Babylon them went too far. So what? We had was fi bun to care. And one and two innocent get mar. But what? Not so it go sometime in a war, E-Star. Not so it go sometime in a war. Them say we burn down the judge, we could have burn the landlord. We burn down the judge, we never burn the landlord. When we run riot all over Brixton, when we mash up plenty police van, when we mash up the wicked one plan, when we mash up the swamp 81. Them say we command the air car and we gather ammunition. We build a barricade and the wicked catch afraid. We send out, we scout, we go find them whereabout. Then we farm up, with posse and we make we raid. Well now them run gang a plan counter action. But the plastic bullet and the water cannon will bring a blam blam, we'll bring a blam blam. Never mind scar man, we'll bring a blam blam. But tell me something, Mr. Government man, tell me something. How long you really feel you woulda keep way under heel when the truth done reveal? But how you grab and speak, but how you make your crooked deal, make your crooked deal, eh? Down in South Hall, we impeach the dead fall. The Asians, them farm up a human war. Against the fascists and them police shield. And them show that the Asians got plenty zeal. Got plenty zeal. Got plenty zeal. It is no mystery. We're making history. It is no mystery. We're winning victory. It is no mystery. We're making history. It is no mystery. We're winning victory. Now tell me something. Mr. Police Spokesman, tell me something. How long you really think we wouldn't take your baton lick? Your jackboot kick, your dirty bag of trick and your racist politics. Your racist politics, eh? We're down in Bristol, they have no pistol. But them chase the Babylon away. And you should have seen your Babylon. How them really run away. You should have seen your Babylon. Them pick up that day. Pick up that day. Pick up that day. It is no mystery. We're making history. It is no mystery. We're winning victory. It is no mystery. We're making history. It is no mystery. We're winning victory. But tell me something, Mr. Right Wing Man. Tell me something. You really feel we would have grovel and scream when so much murder can't see. When we wound can't heal, when we feel the way we feel, feel the way we feel, eh? Well, there was Topstead, and there was Mossside, and a lot of other places where the police had to hide, and Brixton, and Chapel Down, and a lot of other places that was burned to the ground, burned to the ground, burned to the ground. It is no mystery, we're making history. It is no mystery, we're winning victory. It is no mystery, we're making history. It is no mystery, we're winning victory. To take this opportunity, we have some light on the stage, to introduce you to the members of the dynamic Dennis Bovell Dub Band. On saxophone, on melodica, on flute, Kai Cinquez. On trombone, Klaus Yefos. On guitar, John Kapai. On keyboards, Fabio Macchiori. On percussion, the elder, Tony Yuta. On drums, Daniel Spani. On violin, rude boy Johnny T. On bass, our band leader and musical arranger, Mr. Dennis Bovell. Well, I'm in a bit of a dilemma right now because we have 10 minutes and I don't know what to do in 10 minutes. I'm going to do two numbers. I think it's important I do this one because it's a continuation of the two I just did. Because one of the contributing factors to the last riots we had in England in the black communities was the frightening incidence of black deaths in police custody. There's been an ongoing campaign against this, and I contributed a number to the campaign, and I called it License for Kill. Would I go on jokey jokey? Then the next time now, I know nonsense dance. The way she wind up the place last Christmas dance. The way she love to talk about conspiracy. Me and Christine in the canteen talk about the death of black people in a custody. How not a cat make me out nor no damn dog bark. How nobody I up in a society can offer explanation nor remedy. When Christine lit up her brow like say a row, she a go row. Screw up her face like say a trace, she a go trace. Here are now. You think I just MI5 and James Bond and police and soldier over North Island one? When it comes to black people, Winston, some police in England got license to kill. Well, nothing Christine says surprise me still. But hear me now. What you mean, Christine? I won't tell you that. I must see one idiot. You can't prove that. I won't tell you if you go say that. Christine kiss her teeth, then she cut me with her eye and she said, you want proof? You can't ask Clinton McCurbin about him asphyxiation. You can't ask Joy Gordon about her suffocation. You can't ask Colin Roach if him really shoot himself. And you can't ask Vincent Graham if I him stab himself. But you can ask the commissioner for the license to kill. Ask Sir Paul Condon for the license to kill. You can't ask the Douglas them about the new style baton. And you can't ask Tony Hassan about the death by neglect. You can't ask Marlon Downs if him have any regret. And you can't ask Elga Mal about the mystery I'm there. But you can ask the Barbara about the license they kill. Ask the DPP about the license they kill. You can't ask Ibrahim about the CS gas attack. You can't ask Mrs. Gerard how she get her heart attack. You can't ask Oliver Price about the grip round him neck. And you can't ask Steve Boyce about his death by neglect. But you can ask the PCA for the license for kill. Ask the ACTO for the license for kill. You can ask Maggie Thatcher for the license for kill. And you can ask John Major for the license for kill. You can ask Michael Howard for the license for kill. And you can ask Jack Straw for the rule of law. You can ask Tony Blair if he is a wearer or care about the license for kill. And plenty of police throw them back. Sometimes I think my poor work are crazy. The way Christine would have gone jokey jokey. Then the next time now, I know nonsense dance. The way she wind up the place last Christmas dance. The way she love to talk about conspiracy. Thank you. Grove. If they ask Tony Blair if he is aware or care, how the license fit kill that let the police feel them got. Chosen this song. I'm going to leave you with the unfinished revolution. Now watch out, Mr. Man. We don't like the way you can, and your tans are too long, you know, man. I meditate, yeah, I meditate upon the same songs along. Well, hear me, man. Me not preach, me not teach. Me just assure you how me see it. Because the truth, well, sweet, just like an African beat. Like when you see where you're coming from. Like when you decide which part you reach. So me don't care if you want flex or even go on like you perplex. Let me show you when me see, Mr. Man. Just sit down and fold up like a cabbage. Like say you got no understanding, got no knowledge. Like say you still don't realize that just the other day we chuck off the choking chains of bondage. That in spite of the hatred and disadvantage, when we slip up and stumble upon the way, we still reach far down Freedom Street, still mindful of the mind fields upon the way. So I beg you, Mr. Man, please come out of your shell. We can't dwell in the past that does favor your own brother. Now that the sun has shined bright, please come out of the doldrums of the dark night. History bigger than me or you, you know. Time can't steal, but it can heal. So shake the dew from out your head, wipe the cobweb from your face. We got no work for do, I wouldn't reach Mount Zion yet. Yes, we put up a solid foundation if it's true. And one and two we will get through if it's true. But we still not in the New Jerusalem yet. The time gon' come again, you can bet. When we have a march on again, you hear me, friend. Mobilize the woman and befriend them again. Even the picnic, them a go join in again. For freedom is not no ideology. Freedom is a human necessity. It can't depend upon no one, somebody. It's up to each and every one away. Me not preach, me not teach, me just assure you how me see it. Because the truth, well, sweet, just like an African beat, like when you see where you're coming from, like when you sight which part you reach. So me don't care if you want vex or even one that can perplex. Me just assure you when I see, Mr. Man. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Linton Kwesi Johnson and the Dennis Bovell Dub Band. Warren Smith, I don't know what you did, but we're so glad you did it. Thank you for bringing him back to Sierra Nevada World Music Festival. Let me see you in England.
Thank you, LKJ. Thank you, Dennis Bovell. And thank you, Sierra Nevada World Music Festival. We're going to set the stage for Jimmy Cole. DJ Carter Van Pelt, would you please play? Afrolicious about to kick it off at the Village Stage. Stone Love coming up later in the dance hall.